Hello friends, today we discuss about systematic zoology, basis of animal classification. Systematic, which is concerned with study of identification, description, nomenclature and classification of the different kinds of the animals. The animal kingdom is well arranged and is very systematic. For systematic study of animals, different animals are divided into minor and major groups on the basis of similarities and differences. And each group is given a particular name depending upon their characteristic. History and basis of animal classification was described by various scientists such as Aristotle, John Ray, and Carlos Linnaeus. Aristotle is also known as father of zoology. He was the first to point out that animals could be grouped on the basis of their characteristic. He classified animal according to presence or absence of red blood. He described as anemia animals without red blood, which are the majority of invertebrates, and anemia animals with red blood, which are the vertebrates. He also classified animal according to the mode of the nutrition, such as herbivorous animal that adapted to eat plant food, and carnivorous meat eater. John Ray, he divided the living organisms into plant and animal kingdom. Each kingdom was classified into phyla, class, order, families, genera, and species. Carlos Linnaeus, he laid the real basis for modern classification and nomenclature. In his Systema Naturae, 10th edition, 1758, he recognized the six classes of animal kingdom, which are mammals, aves, amphibia, pisces, insecta, and worms, other vertebrates. Also, he established the binomial nomenclature, by which each organism is given a name made up of two Latin words. First is generic name, means genus, and the second is species name, means specific name. Both names are written underlined or in italic. The generic name start with a capital letter, while the species name start with a small letter. Some important bases which are used in animal kingdom classification are presence or absence of cellular differentiation, type of symmetry present, number of embryonic germ layer, presence or absence of segmentation, means metamerism, appendages, type of body cavity or coelom, skeleton, sex of the animal, and some unique features. Animal kingdom is classified into unicellular organism such as subkingdom protozoa, while multicellular organism such as subkingdom metazoa. Multicellular organisms are structurally and functionally different but yet possess certain common fundamental features. The cells of the metazoans are not capable of independent existence and exhibit division of labor. Type of symmetry present. Symmetry is the arrangement of body parts around a central plane or axis. The simplest body plan is seen in sponge porifera. They do not display symmetry and are asymmetrical. Symmetrical animals have pair body parts that are arranged on either side of a plane passing through the central axis. When any plane passing through the central axis of the body divides an organism into two identical parts, it is called radial symmetry. Animal which possess two pair of symmetrical sides are said to be bilateral symmetrical. Number of embryonic germ layer. During embryonic development, the tissue and organ of animals originate from two or three embryonic germ layers. on the basis of origin and development, animals are classified into two categories, diploblastic and triploblastic. Animals in which the cells are arranged into two embryonic layers, the external ectoderm and internal endoderm, are called diploblastic animals. Animals in which the developing embryo has three germinal layers are called triploblastic animals and consist of outer ectoderm, inner endoderm, and middle mesoderm. Most of the triploblastic animal show organ system level of organization. Next is metamerism. Metamerism is the linear repetition of parts in an animal body. Each repeated unit is called segment or metamere or somite. This phenomenon is characteristic mainly for phyla such as Annelida, Arthropoda, and Chordata. Appendages. These are protruding parts from animal body which serve for locomotion, feeding, and other functions. Example of appendages are the tentacle of sea anemone, legs of arthropods, and fins, legs, and wings of vertebrates. Type of body cavity or coelom. The presence of body cavity or coelom is important in classifying animals. Most animals possess a body cavity between the body wall and the alimentary canal and is lined with mesoderm. Animals which do not possess body cavity are called acoelomates. In some animals, the body cavity is not fully lined by mesodermal epithelium, but the mesoderm is formed as scattered pouch between the ectoderm and endoderm. Such a body cavity is called pseudocoelomate. Eucoelomate or true coelom is a fluid-filled cavity that develops within the mesoderm and is lined by mesodermal epithelium cells called peritoneum. Such animal with a true body cavity are called coelomate or eucoelomates. Skeleton. Most animals have some sort of skeleton for support, protection, and aids in locomotion. The skeleton may external, example coral and insect, or internal, example frog and man. It may be either organic or inorganic material. Sex of the animal. If the male and female sex organ are found in the same individual, the same animal is called bisexual or hermaphroditic or monoecious, that is two sex is united, example earthworm and liver fluke. While in most higher phyla, each individual is either male or female and the animal called unisexual or gonochoristic or dioecious, that is two sex is separate, example frog and man. Some unique features. These are special character structures to phylum of the animal, such as nidocytes, nematocytes, example phyla Nidaria, Cylindrata, flame cells, excretory organ, example phylum Platyhelminthes, flatworm, Nephridia, excretory organ, example phylum Annelida. This is the flow chart of kingdom Animalia. Kingdom Animalia is divided into two subkingdom, subkingdom Protista and subkingdom Metazoa. Phylum Protozoa is included in subkingdom Protista, unicellular organism. Subkingdom Metazoa. Subkingdom Metazoa is further divided into two division, such as Perazoa and Eumetazoa. In Perazoa, phylum Porifera include. Eumetazoa is subdivided into two subdivision, diploblastic and triploblastic. Phylum Cylindrata is included in subdivision diploblastic. Triploblastic is further divided into three groups, acoelomate, pseudocoelomate, and coelomate. Phylum Platyhelminthes is included in acoelomate. Phylum Ascelminthes is included in pseudocoelomate, and In Coelomate, the phylum included are Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata, and Chordata. Thank you.